Hi, I'm Tony. I've recently retired as a dentist, and when I approached retirement, I was worried about what I was going to do with all this free time. And so I've always played around on my computer and I've made a dental app, which is something I would have liked a little bit earlier. I've sent it to all my patients over the last couple of years, and I hope you like it, and I hope this gives you a bit of an understanding in how you can use IT. You don't have to be brilliant at it. It's just knowing a bit at a time. And hopefully this will help support you and make your working day a lot easier. Yeah, I changed it to 2 hours CPD, as you can see here, because in order to get a certificate, I think you have to show evidence that you've done the course. And the evidence would be registering on the app. So there's a catch. You can always give yourself an hour if you decide not to register on the app, but you'd miss out on all the fun. You always give a bit about yourself, I think, at these talks, so nobody knows me really apart from our peer review group. I would thoroughly recommend doing peer review, but obviously it's tricky at the moment. But I think it was the best thing we ever did. And I was a trainer for 20 years, and the reason I was a trainer, I had a really bad start at the first 3 years working in practices without a principal. And as an example, I can now tell you that I did some apiectomies. I couldn't view them on YouTube because, well, we didn't have computers. And so I'd never really seen an apiectomy. I was about four back in the queue when we were looking at one of our trainers at university doing it. So I looked it up in a book. I don't think you get away with that now. And anyway, they went quite well. But needless to say, the amount of apiectomies I've done, I can count on one hand. And I like messing about on my computer. But I do have a life. And I was just retired. And a lot of my patients and friends say, well, how will you know? Because I have taken rather a lot of holiday. Anyway, the app, you can download it from the App Store and Google Play. If it doesn't work, I'm afraid it's probably because you're using an obscure phone or an out-of-date phone. Well, you get tax relief on buying your phone, can't you? You know, so get a half decent one and this will work. So yeah, you know, it makes sense. I think some of the older generation, oops, yeah, the older generation, someone trying to get hold of me, the older generation tend to not actually keep up. And that's one of the things I've found is that when you mention an app, and I can talk at length about it, the people I've met, but for one, Sarah Hurley, I'm sure you know with the name, she wanted me to demonstrate the app at the NEC. I got a little letter saying, come and I thought, fantastic, they're going to start using my app. Brilliant. And when I saw it, she said, oh, I don't know about these apps, and passed me on to someone else. And he said, well, you know, and this was another guy about my age, and he said, oh, well, we're not sure about this. And he passed it me on to someone younger and heard nothing back. So I'm not sure else, I don't think, to be honest, she knows much about NHS dentistry, as I'm sure you're aware, because was it? Oh, yes, silver diamine fluoride. Oh, now that's a different topic, which I could talk at length about. But yeah, anyway, let's move on. So this is the time slots, and for those who want to cheat, then you can just dive into the little points and learn how to put yourself on the app. However, you'd miss out on what I hope will be a bit of fun, and if not fun, a little bit that'll make you think different. And we all need to think different, as Steve Jobs is meant to have said. And it's quite interesting, some of his attitudes, but a lot of it was from reading around the subject and thinking different. In all businesses, you come across this funneling model, but the same applies to your education. And a lot of you are doing your job because you've done extremely well in exams. If you reverse it, it means that you're more open to different ideas. And that's what I seem to spend most of my time doing, is just thinking about alternatives. When I first started, we did gingivectomies. But no one does them anymore. And also,
a while ago, and I'm not this old, we thought the world was flat. But opinions do change. You have to question things now and again. So the app is basically a way of saving you time. Obviously, you're going to have to spend an hour doing this, but ultimately, it should save you a lot of time in delivering the same oral hygiene message. So on the app here, there are numbers 1 to 5, and just press them to see what they relate to, and I'll show you later on how you get it to work. And you just mention to your patients what you think are appropriate reminders for them, and between you, you can decide. I try to promote it with dentists, hygienists and therapists through social media. I'm not having a great deal of luck, to be frank, and also to the public through a different web page, which is, well, I'm equally good at. So I posted a couple of videos advertising the dental app for the public. The first one's about 50 seconds long, and the second one I made myself at the weekend. You'll know which weekend it is.
It's now even easier to take back control and responsibility for your health. Using the simple free dental app, you and your family will find it easier to keep your teeth for life and avoid more serious diseases. Follow the in-app video instructions. By entering your personal risk factors, scores from your dentist, or those monitored by yourself, and improve your cleaning habits. Save pain and costly dental fees. Download the Teeth for Life app today and press Squeeze Me to begin achieving better oral health.
And the next one I also tried on Instagram. I had the same amount of luck. Oh, great, Mr. T. I can see you've downloaded our app. Have you personalized it? Oh, fantastic, that's what we need. And what are your scores looking like? Let's have a look. No. Yeah, I know green is good. I said it was good, but you haven't completed it. Look, if we look at the plaque, I did your plaque reading today, but this is something you can do at home. There's a little video showing you how to do it and keep on top of things. And the same with the bleeding score that I checked on. But you can do that yourself. Again, there's a video to show you how to do it back at home. No, I think you will be moving. Okay, this is something you should have done with the email I sent you last time, but you can fill in your BPE scores and there's an explanation of what they are here. No, again, you want to keep the figures low, not high. Don't manipulate the figures. And for completion, we've done your BWEs, which again, they're a little bit on the high side, which is not what you want. You may have been under a bit of pressure, have you? No, for someone your age, probably a night guard's better. You have to be careful with children. They have far too many carbonated drinks these days and their teeth just dissolve, as well as they get a little bit on the big side. And so finally, risk factors. Do you smoke? No, all right, good. And drink, you must drink. No, you don't drink. And any stress? No, you are. And your diet's good, you say it's nothing's better than your diet? It's really excellent. Top diet? No, I think it sounds a bit bad. HPV, I'm not going to explain that one. And you think you got no risk, but the papers say you're probably quite high. And who knows about your diabetes? Frankly, it's best if you fill this in at home yourself and have a little play around with it, because you might get a different score. So if we look at your scores, they look pretty good, all things considered. But if, with lockdown that we have and anything else, and you decided to have a couple of drinks and maybe have the odd cigar, then I think your scores are going to get a fair bit worse. So shall we have a little look? Oh, God, yeah, no, they're a lot worse. So that's the last thing you want to do in the lockdown. Oh, you don't believe in lockdown. Well, anyway, with regards to your health, having good oral hygiene can improve your general health. So what I'd recommend is you check yourself kind of weekly to try and improve your bleeding in the gums, because that's not healthy. And of course, even keep checking yourself for oral cancer or any other kind of cancer that we've listed within our videos. And finally, I've highlighted the areas where you're not quite catching cleaning your teeth and where there's some pockets. And yeah, we just deleted where you haven't got any teeth. It's no surprise you've got no wisdom teeth. Yep, the videos are all there under my care. And well, this is the section for an adult, but there are sections there for teenagers, children, and those who are carers. They're a neglected group of people, and carers need to learn how to do that. We've added a section for dental emergencies because it's a bit tricky to see the dentist at the moment. And we've also got the section for the hygienists, and just explains what the procedures are that they do for you. Who's registered? Oh, you haven't got anyone registered. Well, to find a dentist or a hygienist nearby, just type in your postcode and it'll bring any dentist up that's got the app or the hygienist, because they can customize it themselves. So if you type in a postcode here, you'll find me. And there are some details about me, and you can add me as your dentist, or you can add a hygienist. And then we just put down a little bit about what we do. We all have slightly different interests, and this is a way to promote them and for you to understand what they are. And obviously we got our contact details as well. No, you don't have to pay. Your wife sorted it out. She realises the value of putting you on a prevention plan. Yeah, it's our kind of version of libertarian paternalism, making you make the right decisions. We find people on a plan tend to turn up more regularly and ultimately have less treatment. Yeah, a win-win. Did you ever recommend them in The Apprentice? Oh, no, you can't sue me because your teeth are wobbling out. All the advice I've given you over the years is clearly on the computer. We don't care if you've got the biggest and bestest lawyers in the land. The email trail shows that we've given you all the correct advice and you haven't followed it. It's your fault. You are responsible for your oral health. We can't be there 24/7. But of course, your phone is, I know from all the tweets. So apply it in a better way and download the app and start following the advice we give you. So I hope you found that, it was meant to be humorous, to engage the public. And this is where I've made my videos. And you can see from the bottom left, I had an original iMac when I did desktop publishing, when I started my last practice about 25 years ago. You wouldn't believe how poor computers were back then. I'm sure I'll mention it again later. So I know PCs have improved massively. All you'll need to do to put yourself on the app is to be able to write and cut and paste and import photos, and that's about it. Or maybe learn how to use import URLs. And this is the person I've used more recently on how to do things on my app, like make videos and use pages. So these were, if you look on YouTube, you'll find a lot of these videos. Obviously, a lot of them are really, really poor, but hopefully it'll show there's been some improvement. I have had feedback in the past from other dentists and some friends, and generally the friends don't like looking in people's mouths, surprisingly. So I have made some animations. I've moved over to animations with some software that you can use. And these are pictures that I've had to make. And so currently I'd say the next video is actually just to demonstrate to myself really what we can do using these things, and it will improve rapidly over the next few years. So this is quite relevant in November. In these unprecedented times, we need to be monitoring ourselves more closely than ever. We need to inspect our bodies regularly for lumps and bumps or new abnormalities. This video concerns the mouth. Check your lips, the roof, and the sides of your mouth, including the tongue. Like all cancers, oral cancer has not gone away with COVID, and you should inspect yourself monthly for this largely preventable but deadly disease. As with all diseases, early diagnosis improves outcomes, and you should be the first to notice. Like most skin lesions, a dated photograph on your phone helps with early diagnosis, as a patient did here for me. This is one of many causes of ulcers in the mouth, a sharp tooth. There are more details on the free Teeth for Life app, which includes video oral hygiene advice and can be personalised for your own scoring and setting appropriate reminders to improve habits. Download the Teeth for Life app now and press Squeeze Me to start enjoying better health.
But right, for your CPD certificate, you'll have to get onto the app. And in fairness, I think I'm just going to show you videos that are already readily available. But on the app, there's a thing called Postcode Finder, which is where anyone who wants to find a dentist can type in their postcode and they'll bring them up here. So I don't come here, this is a virtual one. I just made it up. And I'm here and I'm there. So what you want is that you will need to actually write a little bit of blurb about yourself. So if you want to find me in your app, type in the postcode there and it'll bring me up here. Then you can add me as your dentist and you can see some of the things that I've written as blurb for me. There's also my biography. It's not that interesting, use your own. And the idea is that you have a presence there. And obviously it looks like you've made a lot of effort, which you've made almost an hour's effort, if not a bit more, but you can continue to customize it. So I will authorize it if I can find you on the postcode finder. I'm not going to check your personal profile. But on the next part, so what tends to happen is this. I'm going to have to change my slide slightly. Right, yeah, this. So I have a spoof site as well. If you type in ho, 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 it comes up here. And so I've had a lot of people who've registered, but not actually changed it a great deal. So they can't be found, and so they default to this chap. This is the same, it's Movember. And obviously I took part in Movember a couple of years ago. It's gone a bit quiet now, a bit like oral cancer awareness, unfortunately, but oral cancer happens every day, as does prostate cancer. Anyway, so, and this is what I put on for the spoof one. I did it last Christmas. So as you can see, I look a lot better here. And if I could afford it, I'd get a full head of hair again. And I just made up a load of stuff there. So you can have a look, but I wouldn't use any of the advice here. And this is a default. So basically, if you look at the services and you've got these three, it means you haven't entered any of your services. Well, that's not really trying. So you have to do a bit more. I'll let you off the video, but this I added in the last 6 months, I think. So some of you who registered a year ago won't have this availability, so you may want to go back. You can add YouTube links. So it'll only take YouTube links. And most of the big companies have links on YouTube. So if you want to do a tooth whitening one, if you want to do Invisalign, they're all there as just find a link. And I think, yeah, on my YouTube channel, I think I've highlighted links that I thought were half decent. So you could simply go there and copy them. And when you register, you'll look here. So I have actually got about 350 people registered, and I had to block out the details because of GDPR. Is it GDPR? Anyway, GDPR. So that's why they're blanked out. And I would say half the people properly registered, and the other half aren't. Well, if you go on yourself. And you would have put in your email address and you've forgotten your password, unless it's like 1234, which you use for everything. So this section does work. So you'll, sign in, you forgot your password, get back in. And then look here, if you haven't added your password, your postcode, it defaults to the North Pole. Yeah, I was there, Santa at North Pole. And I made up some daft stuff. Yeah, what's that website, present for us, present for you or something. So you don't want this, you press that and remove it and put in your practice.
So to show everyone else what this entails, you can go into the YouTube channel and go to the playlist. There's one on registering via mobile, but I recommend registering via your computer or your workstation at work because it's easier to move text and pictures around there. I've never made a video this long before, so I've decided to do it in 3 bits, so move on to the next one.
I'm sure I'll keep adding and taking bits away with your feedback. So this is nearly a minute of filler, so I can get the timings right for the next two videos. So, oh yeah, so that's a lesson you learn. Learn by my mistakes and don't trim your post crown without eye protection. That was in 1983. And a big thank you to Denise, who's been my assistant for a long time. I could never have enjoyed my work so much without her great help. And when we started, it was quite chilled, but when we finished, got hot.
These are some basic instructions on how to register for the dental app via the careforteeth.co.uk website, and it's just like most other sites that you'll go onto. Enter your practice email address and your GTC number to register for the account. Try to remember your password. Once you're registered, you can update your biography. So you go into My Bio, and it's useful to have some idea on what you want to say about yourself, and you can cut and paste that in, and you can do the same with a photo, which clearly has been manipulated here. You can also include your social media links if you have any. Once you've submitted your biography update, you then move on to practices, and then just add your practice details. It's important that you put the zip code in, your postcode, because that's how you'll be identified through the dental app itself, by a user putting in your postcode. Add the practice phone numbers, the practice reception email address, and any of the practice social media all go in this section. When you put in the hours, put the practice opening hours in rather than your own individual hours. And if you work at a different practice, you can upload the practice details here as well. And if you move on, then you can simply delete them and upload the next practice. You can customize the app further by including some areas of interest that you may have or areas of expertise, and just have a little bit of detail regarding this, including some photos, before and after cases, or even we can now add YouTube links to explain to the patients what the process involves. So basically, we'll do your advertising for you, or at least you can direct your patients to this area. And again, it should be relatively easy to upload new details and remove ones that are out of date. You can update your app details at any time by simply logging in using your password and using the procedure shown earlier. If you have any problems or have any suggestions, please get back to me using this email address. So for further information, which is probably easier to access rather than this video, go back to the registration page. It's got lots of details on there that probably be replicated by me just talking about them now. There are lots of video links, but clearly if I change it on YouTube, then the link goes and I have to replace it, so I'll have to chase that one up. Where are we with resources? You skip through that. Right, resources, yeah, there's the video links. I must have made some video links telling you about the app. And yeah, so most of the links, a lot of video made on Vimeo, which are the ones within the app, and there are good reasons for that rather than YouTube. I've used Dropbox a fair bit, and a bit like most people, I'm a bit untidy in some ways, and certainly on my app, I'm a bit, or Dropbox, I'm a bit untidy, needs tidying up. But the links all work, so to do it yourself, I can make a video, or I have made a video showing you how you can add your own audio to the videos that I've made, certainly the animations. Now that would be useful for you. The templates, the cards, they'll be there. And it would be better if we could have a PDF. I never got around to sending my patients a PDF, because obviously given a card at the moment with COVID, it's a bit awkward, but print off a PDF showing their tooth map would be useful. The next bit, not sure where I'm going here. Resources. Yep, I shouldn't have gone back there. Right, and then what are we saying? How to score? Well, yeah, you've seen these in the video, and obviously I made the video on scoring. I think the one I did for, or tried to explain it to Mr. Trump was, well, I thought it was reasonably funny. But of course, when I was making it, Biden got in, so it was just slightly out of sync. You have to be careful. But anyway, so have a look through this. It's a lot easier than listening to me. Now, how to use. Right, so if you've gone through all the effort of putting yourself on the app, there's no point if nobody knows that you're there. So you need to modify, or your manager needs to modify the appointment reminder if you send by email or by text, just to say that you have an app available and to find you on the app. The second stage is reception area marketing. I've made some videos so that when people were sitting in the reception, they could look at the screen and they may download the app then, and some instructions on how to use it. The direct marketing, stage three, is when they're in the surgery. So I used to give the patients a card, certainly the first time I saw them, and always send an email and just check that they got the email before they left the surgery. And the following email, I suppose, is the same thing. Is you will know they have got the email with the details about their BPE on. So I think that's your protection. So, there's the mail merge there. And so I had instructions on how it would work with SOE. So different people will have something similar within their software. And yeah, so that still works. And then what else was there? There was, all right, the references. So I referred to this earlier. There are a few videos. This one's the most viewed YouTube video of all time. And sadly, he's just died. And that's about the funnel I was talking about. With regard to Mr. Oliver, that there are some references in that in some of my videos. As there is about The Habit from Duhigg, I think his name is. And the other one is the most interesting at all. So I'd ask you to look at that, especially when it comes to COVID and what our experiences are. So we need to be led by science, but sometimes experience works, often from outside the medical field. The app's been made through kind of the lean startup method, which basically means you can develop it as you go along. And that's where feedback would be really useful. And then these were just some ideas on how I think the app can help you. And I like the one on empathy and time. You can't buy them, but in some ways you can. So this is the follow-up email I sent to Donald Trump. Well, actually, I never did see him. But if you read it, you can see how it kind of covers yourself. And also it promotes, you know, oral cancer awareness. But you can put whatever you want in there. You may want to put in, remind them about tooth whitening or implants, whatever. But again, it's just a bit of marketing.
How to set up a template. And obviously, emails are generally free, or SMS. So I'm sure there's other ways of doing it, and different companies do different things. And maybe SOE have changed it. But you just need to play around with it. And I'd just recommend that you send it, yeah, like I did, to myself. So these were my templates. You know, this is one on interdental brushing, which is why I started in the first place. I had a really good result with someone. And so you just click in and you can see the fields and what have you. And really, it is a question of editing and adding and or just pinching someone else, basically, and copying and pasting. Oh, so here's my description for a molar apiectomy. So I use that one a lot, I can tell you. And then you just start to fill it in. And that's will show you how you sound, cut and paste. So I think you saw this, or there's certainly reference to it in a video explaining in greater depth in the registration site. So, you know, just have a go. And then once you've made it for your molar apiectomies, then crack on, do them and check on your insurance. Well, I've included this picture because I started the practice back in, as it says there, 96, and gradually extended it, and it ended up being what I think is a nice place with six surgeries. But we finished it in 2006, and we didn't get the funding, and we didn't get extra UDAs. And suddenly, from being 95% NHS, which is why I started the business, we were in trouble. So that's kind of coloured my opinion. This also coloured my opinion is that I made my first website because I sold the practice eventually because I didn't want to kind of work in as much as I did. So I sold it, and unfortunately my dad had dementia, and so I decided to try and learn how to make a website because I treated a lot of carers and they never had any advice. And so that was my main motivation. And I put these slides in the wrong order because the first slide I wanted to do was make one for our local LDC. I was on the LDC for about 25 years. And the thing about it is I found out that there was a brilliant site already, and it had everything that you wanted on it. So we shouldn't have individual areas given individual advice for whether it's bisphosphonate advice or the antibiotic advice. It should be all central, and you just have a local part. So you have one or two people keep the thing up together who are far more knowledgeable than I am, and someone who just maintains it with the local meetings, and that would work for everyone. I mean, of course, now we've just got I've got Siri. Well, actually, no, you do need, and you should support the LDC, otherwise it will fall apart. The next bit is, so when we started the practice, I did desktop publishing, so I made the logo, I made all of this. And this is why, I'll see if I put in a slide about why we pivoted if we have time. But this was very successful at certain times with the recommended friend. You'll have heard it many times before. But the thing about it is that you can connect it with the app because on this you give the patient what they want and hopefully what they want, and certainly what you want them to have with regards to how they look after themselves. They are responsible for themselves. So here where I've written this, it was just because I was trying to promote the app. But you can put whatever you want here. So obviously you put your name and your phone number, whatever, you can promote them to the app, but you can also tell them that you do to look up your details on Invisalign if you're doing Invisalign, and if you're doing implants, which most people would want to do, and often you end up having to advertise to supplement the difficulties that you have working within the main NHS system as it is, rather than the core service that we all wanted. And this is back after I sold it, I was interested in apps, but they basically didn't do what you wanted them to do. So it didn't have a scoring system in. And actually, if you looked at it really closely, it was, you know, don't get me wrong, my app is a template, but this was a template that was used for a multitude of services, but nothing like what we do. So that's why I ended up making my own. And this is a Father's Day present from a daughter. I said I'd never show anyone this again, and I'm going to stick to it. But it was they're very powerful, and obviously, if you can have a patient who will give a testimony for you, it works extremely well, and you obviously put it on your app.
So I think you've got enough details to put yourself on the app and get your CPD. and this is a good time to have a break. So just guess where I am in both of these while you reload, so to speak. And the next section should be, I hope, sort of thought-provoking and interesting, but not necessarily all about the app, but hopefully make your working day more interesting. Okay, so this is a catch-all. Well, that was where I grew up, and I still haven't grown up then. And as you can see here, I still haven't grown up. But I was in India in lockdown, and we stayed here. There was about 20 of us in the hotel, and so I had time to play around with my iPad. So this is a software I call Brushes. And so I did this when I was in Palma on holiday, and I was waiting for someone to get ready. So I quickly scribbled some things together, and you can see roughly how it works here. So I hope you spotted the logo that I kind of did. Some slight improvement there. And also I thought this could be improved upon. I think the person who ever did it was in sort of a lousy mood or something. So I thought, well, what the heck, I wonder if I can brighten it up. And I did. And this must be worth a fortune, because it was far better than the original. And this kind of thing did come in handy, although I didn't know. But when I was stuck in Mumbai, I made a few pictures of teeth. And this you might recognise because, well, it was in the video on oral cancer. And so I learned that all messing about on my iPad. And about 5 years ago, I went to Vegas. It was slightly different there. Celebration was because Serona and Dentsply had just merged. There were 5,000 American dentists at this meeting. I don't know why they were so pleased, because I'm sure the fees went up. I was advised to go to the States for lectures more than 30 years ago, and CEREC's been going for 30 years. I was particularly interested in a new material that I was using, and it had been stopped. The reason was not because the material was poor, but the dentists were using it poorly, and being the company was being sued, so they withdrew the product. Anyway, we had a nice room, and it was quite motivational in some funny way. So when I first started, we didn't have IT, we had yellow pages, and people used to pay a lot of money just to have a half page spread or a full page spread. Now it's changed to having web pages, and this is the kind of figures that you would pay to have a half decent and a top range web page, and this is by the company that I used myself back in the day. But you do realise that about a third of the people looking at the site are actually bots. So what you can do is you convert your web page into a mobile web page, so it views better on your phone. But the difference when you have an app is it can be personalized, as you can see. People can score themselves, and also you can actually direct them to your website anyway. Especially if you're keen on online booking, but I must say I'm not. So back in the 80s I went on a programming course. And it's then that I realised how interesting dentistry was. And I also found a local dentist whose brother was a programmer, and he made a great software called Dental Systems Design. And it was excellent. I used it for about 10 years, and I used to call in to see the programmers now and again if we had any issues. It was a very interesting time, but unfortunately, as these things happen, it got bought out by a bigger company. And whilst they said they were going to support it, they didn't. And the service we received and the actual software itself, in my view, was worse. You only need software that does what you want it to do, not pay for extra stuff that you don't need. And many have now gone to cloud-based systems, and I hear these are very good, but it may not last. So when I went to Vegas, people had just moved over from these red cams, so you got them secondhand, don't buy one. I had a blue cam, it needs a powder. and had some great results, but definitely don't buy one. And the Omnicam, I think, came out about 5 years ago, and these are excellent. So I would consider one of these, especially as it includes the milling machine. So this chap's working with the Prime Scan. Obviously it's pre-COVID, and with these, really, you don't have to do much thinking. It does everything for you. And it costs less than what I paid for my Blue Cam 10 years ago. This Prime Scan uses AI technology using GANs, and the same thing applies when you send off your things for Invisalign. This AI designs everything for you, but clearly you're responsible for whatever outcomes you get. And intraoral cameras have improved a great deal, as you can see here. You can see a chipped tooth, or chipped crown rather, which is the black bit. Quite healthy gums, not quite sure what's going on there. But I know there's been a lot of grinding going on, and that's a chipped bonded crown. But there's the camera, and oh, that's me. And these are cheap. So perhaps one of these cameras, plus say a free dental app, might be a better way of looking after your mouth, and a lot cheaper. This next bit uses AI as well. I'd probably advise that you turn off the volume and come back and then just look at the video again. I'm going to explain how it works.
El litigio dental es un problema. Parece haber aumentado después del milenio. Entonces...
So the animations that I've used, they've got a very similar name to this one. So I downloaded this stuff thinking it was the same as I was using, and it clearly it wasn't. And so what it does is that you can talk to it and it will decide which animations to use. Now clearly it's not working that brilliant, and clearly it hasn't got many dental ones, so I've played around with it a bit. But I can't speak Spanish. But using this technology, I can speak 50 different languages. And I know that I can populate it with more appropriate images. So if I can do it, so that's the one image that I made, and I think it's to do with a partial denture. In a few years' time, this will be an awful lot better. So the thing we have to remember is we'll always need our personal skills, we'll always have our dexterous skills, but this kind of thing improves rapidly, and that's why I think you should get involved in at least being aware of what it can do. So go back to the start and turn off the volume and just see what I'm saying here, because I think your average general dentist, and average isn't the right term, but your general dentist often should be valued more than the specialists, and they have created a problem, I feel, and with regards to the public's expectations and the reality of what we can provide under the current services. And I touched on this before with regards to when you're using AI, who is responsible ultimately. And the same thing applies for associate dentists and hygienists, is that if you have self-employed status, you are probably more likely to be responsible for your actions. But if you work for a corporate and you're employed by the corporate, then who is responsible then? I'm never quite sure about this, but it is an issue that should be addressed. I spent an awful lot of time filling in forms that really weren't to cover me, but were to cover the corporate that I worked for. Back in about 84, when I was working in a satellite practice, it was a grubby place, but the sterility was good, especially as we weren't wearing gloves back then. And I asked a patient complained to me about the premises, but not my treatment. And I asked her to complain because we were all cheesed off with it as well. And ultimately what happened was I ended up in front of the GDC with a full hearing, and I was found responsible and advised to go and find another practice, which I did. And I went and worked in a private practice, and that was great. I really enjoyed it, but I didn't earn any money, and so I had to move on. I've done a few surveys, and I have got one going at the moment, which is to try and get support for prevention. I've approached the NHS, but they say that they need to see results. Well, if no one views the app, then I won't get any results. And as I said before, on social media, I'm not particularly good, and I've actually run out of money to spend a lot on advertising. So please complete the survey. I'll just put the details on here. And yes, I think at the very end of here, I'll just leave it frozen. as a profession, I think we should be angling towards general health rather than just making people have a pretty smile. So, yesterday I asked my phone what singularity was, and it told me, and it also gave me this printout. We've nothing to fear from computers because they'll never be able to do any fillings, but they can really assist us when it comes to our knowledge. And it's strange that back in the day, I was never really taught much about business. You picked it up as you went along. And the same with IT. There are no courses that we can get CPD on, which just seems ridiculous in this day and age. So I taught myself how to make QR codes. The one on the left is for a download for the free app. The one on the right is on how to use interdental brushes. And I asked Boots and Sainsbury's if they would use the one on the right with the interdental brushes, because you can see people looking rather mysteriously at them when you go around the supermarket, and it costs nothing to put these next to them to explain how they work. To throw in a few references, these are all the audiobooks that I've listened to over the years, and obviously I've listened to different podcasts as well, and I learn a lot on YouTube, and I learn a lot of it for free, which is why the Teeth for Life YouTube channel is clearly free, and you can download all the videos, and as I said before, I can make a video showing you how to add your own audio. So this is interesting in a kind of way, in that if you actually look at the green paper that they published, dentistry gets a mention of almost two paragraphs about water fluoridation, which was around in the 60s when I was growing up, and also looking after the under fives. Other than that, nothing. So I'm just going to talk over and be a bit rude and mention some of the things that I could do in the future. But first off is something that I did in the past, which is called a pivot. It's when I changed my mind, and this is thanks to my son, because when I told him about my idea of initially taking pictures of people's mouths using this smile light, he said it was a very rude word, and another rude word, idea, because people wouldn't let you touch their phones. And he was right. And that's why I brought out those cards. Yeah, and also they cost £500. And I didn't think any associate would pay that amount of money for one. And I never got around to this, which is making a PDF that you can adjust and get printed out at reception rather than use the cards. I'm pretty sure we can set up teledentistry quite easily. And as I said, it's allowed in the States using FaceTime and Zoom. So I could add a suitable booking calendar within the app for that. Lots of apps use location services, so that should be a reasonable thing that we could add rather than the postcode. The app is GDPR compliant, but I think we could activate notifications, and as long as they're not too irritating, just promote general health. And finally, I could customise the front page. I think there would obviously be a charge for this, but for bigger practices, it might work. And this is where we have our peer review, and as I can't recommend them highly enough, as I've said many times. Through a particular website, I met someone who knew a bit more about silver diamine fluoride, and then I put it all together on a web page over a weekend. There's a blog page in it, and I think this is really good. He said modestly, but there's a variety of blogs. I'm not quite sure how the blogs work. I know no one's looked at them, but this blog in particular is all about emotional intelligence, I think, in that whilst this is all about how to use IT, the best thing you can do is talk to your patients. And there are certain ways of doing it and certain ways of communicating and being personable that no robot will ever help you with. So I'd urge you to read this. It'll save you a lot of time and money with regards to potential litigation. So if anyone's interested in the process of how I've done the app, then obviously please get in touch. And I just made a little presentation on the latest webpage that we made on minimal invasive dentistry. So I hope you like that.
Website a couple of months ago, one weekend. It was after Sarah Hurley, I think, who said, recommended the SPECT technique and the silver diamine fluoride that I'm pretty sure not many average dentists knew about. But anyway, I've always been interested in prevention, which is clear what the app's about. And so I come across people who knew a lot more about silver diamine fluoride than I did, and a lot more about prevention than I did. So we've made this page, and this chap has lectured on it extensively, and obviously a very keen promoter of it, so you can read about him there, as I wouldn't read about me. I think the prevention is all about the app, really, and so we'll skip that. So this bit, MID, has looked through all these different kinds of treatments minimal treatments that you can do. So, and the vast majority of it is inputted by a lot of other people rather than me. And I've got some blogs. I like CADCAM, I think that's minimal. And the blog here, some of these things, like the whole technique, and it's now academic, but it wasn't originally. And just I have a strong opinion that sometimes we don't always act in the patient's best interests. So it's fortunately now I've retired, so I'm guessing nothing can happen to me. This is excellent. I'll have mentioned that earlier. And minimal veneer as well, that's a good one. The other one is this. The notes we used to do were very minimal. And they seem to get a lot of work done quite quickly using amalgam. And I'm not, you know, there has to be a balance. So these are my views here. And this is an interesting one. Anyway, going back, sorry. Teledentistry, well, this I think will be empty. Oh, no, it's not. But the idea is, in the future, we will be doing teledentistry. Well, clearly, we won't be doing any restorations, but we can give advice, and certainly oral hygiene advice. And that's what's happening in the States now with following COVID. There's a lot more. So lots of orthodontists are doing it. If you do Invisalign, you're probably doing it. If you're not, well, probably should be. Ethics, well, I can't remember what I put here. Divide and rule. Right, okay. All right, so this bit's interesting. It's about a few years ago when I was in the LDC, I was trying to get everyone's emails in case we ever had a problem. And obviously the GDC said no. They didn't want all the dentists to be able to communicate with one another, heaven forbid. So, but bizarrely, with COVID, you all got emails. I can't quite remember why now, but this is something that I wrote about 3 years ago. I think I mentioned it earlier about when I did a web page. Resources, right, the resources, Apple audiobooks, Future Learn, YouTube, the books I've had, right, they're all, nearly all non-dental. I'm guessing that some of the information I've just picked up from dentistry. Peer review, it's the best thing that we've done, and it's proper CPD. You interact. It's a shame we can't do it now. This was really good on Future Learn. There's one Future Learn on dentistry, which is taking pictures, and I've done it, but clearly it didn't really impact on me if you see the quality of my pictures. And yeah, so this kind of thing. So I have met Ian Chappell, excellent speaker, Bartlett. He was impressed with, I don't know if he's impressed, but he'd never seen these graphics which I made. You know, I think you have to keep interested in what you're doing. Oh yes, and I did a dental symposium, and that was obviously to promote my app, but I spent more time chasing everyone else. So we would, we did Invisalign implants and CADCAM. Why we're not doing more CADCAM, I don't know. And
that's enough, I think. If I hope that I'm able to sign you off and that you register for the app, that's the main idea. And please share it. That's The main aim is that people start looking in the mouths a little bit more. I'm talking about the general public. And, you know, the strapline of save for life, share teeth for life is a good one, I think. But if you have any feedback, give it to me. As you can see, we're yet to really hit dizzy heights of having double members. But if anything comes up, I'll post it here when I work out how to use it.
These mobile phones weren't invented when I qualified. There's a bloody bird there. When I qualified, we didn't have mobile phones. We didn't have these kind of cameras. But we did know that prevention was better than cure. It's something I think Matt Hancock said, a couple of years ago. So look, let's not bother waiting for the government and let's get the public on our side. You can make a video of yourself and put it on the app, and that way, you know, it'll help with your empathy. And you can give your feedback on the YouTube channels saying how I can improve them. So go on, make your own testimonial. It's got to be better than this. I'm in a rush, Liverpool are on the telly.
This is just a video showing you how you can customise or personalise the videos that I've made for yourself. And I think that helps with empathy, whatever. And you can add them to the app, which I hope you've downloaded. And you can add them in your customised section, or just simply email them to your patients. That's how I started, with just emailing my patients YouTube videos that I thought would be useful. So and as before, if you have a problem, get back to me. And I've tried to make it quite simple, and you're all varying ability. So for some of you, it'll be a bit dull, and for some of you, you probably need a bit more. So like I say, get back in touch. So I was trying to work out how to do it myself, and I was struggling a bit. And of course, what you should do with anything is go to YouTube. And then I found out that the easiest way to do it is the way that I've done most of the videos more recently, when I've been trying to make a webinar. So I'll mention that at the end. Anyway, so look up most stuff via Google. So nearly everything I've learned more recently has been via this chap for free. And it's I've used Pages, I've used iMovie, which I'll show you how to use now. And it just shows you how to use all different types of software, like Keynote if you're going to do a presentation. And the guy is just brilliant. I'm not trying to copy him, I'm just trying to give you a hand. So go to Applications via your Finder and locate QuickTime. And simply open it by pressing it. And then go to New Screen Recording, as you can see, and it'll open up a box, and you just move the box around, open and expand it and decrease it as you would for any window, and move it around the appropriate video on YouTube. So go to YouTube and download Teeth for Life, look amongst the playlists and decide which video you want to copy, and then move the window around so it only covers the screen, not like I've done here. You'll get a little box at the bottom for player, and you press record. Make sure it says record part of the screen. And on my computer, to stop it, there's a button at the top that suddenly appears in the top menu. And so for further advice, then I just look it up on YouTube. So once recorded, it'll appear on your desktop like that. And so you then need to import it into the Mac iMovie. So like before, you go to the Applications folder, and this time select iMovie and open it up, and it may it'll look like this. And so on mine at the moment, it looks like this. So I just open up the Create New box, and then you start to drag in or import the video that you took. So to personalize it further, you can import your own video. It could be something you've taken on your iPhone. Or just import a picture of yourself or some picture that you like that's personal to you, and it'll make the app make the video more personal to your patients. You can manipulate the videos or the pictures rather. I'll show you in a moment. As before, that's how you adjust the size of them. So here, when you've clipped onto where you've got the yellow border, that means that portion's active. And so at the top there is certain, the blue one is how you can crop the image or put on different a different effect, which is called the Ken Burns effect. So you can play around with that, and all these things. Just play around with them and see how it works for you. The next bit, I think, just showing you how you can add a title. There are lots of different titles to play around with, and you can see the box is active because it's yellow. So the next bit here is with the volume. You shouldn't have any volume on this video. When you record anything from YouTube, I just knock the video off anyway. But there you can see that's how you kind of grab hold of the video if it did have any sound. The best thing I think is just to go back and kick off the sound before you recorded the video from YouTube. And so then it just plays along, as you can see here. So the white line that you can see moving across, so that's gone to the yellow, so that you're at the front of the video there, and that's when you, where you want to be. That's how you record with the microphone, and you get a little bleep signal, and then your voice appears, as you can see there. So you can say what you want, whatever picture you've got there, and you just personalize it a bit about you, and then you can start talking about whatever video you've downloaded. If it's one of mine, then fine. Just be careful if it's someone else's, you have to get their permission. But the idea is to engage the patient with your voice, personalize it, and hopefully you'll get the message across. So these videos you would add to your own personal profile. The other videos within the app are clearly my opinion, and if I'm not with the general consensus, I'm happy to change them. Just give me some feedback. You can add some background audio. Mine's really irritating, you'll see it there. Yeah, it's simple, but you can choose whatever you want. So you just get hold of it and drag it down, and you adjust it in the same way as the others. So like I said before, you can adjust the sound level, and you can move your sound around yourself. So I tend to have obviously my volume higher for myself. I haven't added any background noise for this one, but just play around with it and see what you like. If you're not happy with what you said, then you can always cut it. You can either cut it or drag it. As I said, if you look at some of the videos, it'll explain it far better. And there you can see the buttons again where I've decided to say something different. You can't quite say what I'm adding to the video, but that's how you do it. You just drag and drop, and you can cut just like most other things. So at the end, you forward it. If you've got a YouTube channel, you put it there. More likely you've got Facebook. But generally, I always put it onto my desktop. You can put a title to it. And then you're able to add it to the app. So if you struggle, either go on YouTube or the online help on your computer. And there are a variety of places where you can adjust the sound. So you go into System Preferences, Sound, and that's where you'll find your microphone. So you may want to play around with that a little bit. So I hope you found this useful. And as you're on YouTube, please subscribe. It'll help the public find us.
Like a lot of dentists my age, I'm retiring disillusioned. I want to try and help the public and help young dentists. We're in a right mess, probably because of the lawyers, and probably because, well, in part to ourselves. We really need to promote prevention and be the caring profession that we all are. So please add your comments onto my YouTube videos and I'll gradually improve them. And if you have any ideas, please direct mail me. I'd love to have some feedback. And I hope you enjoy your career. I've really enjoyed mine, although it doesn't show.